Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Rabbi Shrahli Sadri Wayassir Li Amri Wa Ahlul Uqdatam Min Lisani Yafqahu Qawli. Dear boys, today we are going to study the lesson number six of your book too. This is one of your modern assets and out of ten, this is the sixth one. The man who was hospital. This is a story and it's a criticism.
A light criticism upon the people who are always claiming to be expert in everything. Always they are thinking that they know each and everything, and whatever they are talking about, they are talking with authority. Although they are jack of all trades, but they are master of none. But they claim that they can guide each and everybody according to their own best capability. So, in a lighter tone, the writer has thrown the light upon this aspect of life. And this is a story of a man who got a book of pharmacology. And once he went through that book, he came to know that he had each and every malady except only one. What was that? We are going to discuss that one with the help of these notes which are written in front of you on the board. But before going in the deep detail of that one, I think it, I thought it pertinent that we must know about the marks distribution of this your paper. Because we are going to study now, this is the lesson of your book too, and how many marks are allocated for this book. That's very important. We must be in picture about that. Yes, but first of all, look. The total essays, these are 10. Modern essays, these are 10. And this is 6th one. And out of objective type question, that has maximum 10 marks. Out of 3 marks are specified for this essay portion. And these 3 synonyms will be there. Physical words that will be given to you. And 4 options will be lying in front of you. Out of which only one will be right. So you are supposed to choose one of them. Secondly, question answer, that is the second portion of your second part of your paper. So, in which questions will be there? 6 questions are to be answered, against which the student will be given 12 marks. He is supposed to write 3 to 5 lines on every answer of the question. And if he writes correctly, of course, he will be given 2 marks for that one. So, 6 questions are to be attempted, it makes 12. So, as a whole, These ten essays have 15 marks. If you are grasping each and everything, all the synonyms and all the question answers of these 10 essays, of course, you'll mark 15 by 15 out of this portion. And then secondly, let's talk about it, that what's going on. Although we have already studied the text of this book, just for the sake of summary, we can observe here that the writer went somewhere and he studied, a circular was lying there, and when he studied, he came to know that his own liver that was out of order. First time he came across his first problem, that was, he thought about it, that his liver was in trouble. Now, later on, when once again he got the opportunity to go to the British Museum, and again a book of pharmacology that was lying there, and he started opening that casually, and he observed that he had hay fever. Then he observed that he had all the symptoms of these maladies and these diseases. So he became interested in his own case. So what happened, that he started studying all these diseases alphabetically. So he observed that he had all these maladies in him. Like, look, hay fever was there, typhoid, that was also with its symptoms found in him. Then the synovitis dust, that was also there. Bright's disease, that was also found there. Then cholera, he had the symptoms of cholera as well. Diphtheria, that is a disease of the throat, that was also, according to the writer, that was also there. And gout, erythemosis, look, Z, starting with Z. So alphabetically, he observed that all these maladies were found in him. Now, once think about yourself, boys, that if this is happening with you, and if you come to know that you are having all these maladies and diseases in you, what will happen with you? Of course, you will be in trouble. You will be in a hot water. That you will observe that you are going to die, of course, within a few days. So you will be in trouble. But here the situation is totally different with the writer. So only one malady was not found in him. Its symptom was not found. What is that? That is housemaid's name. Now, once he found that he didn't have this disease, so was he happy? No. He thought that this was a slight for me. Slight means insult. He thought that this is a big insult for me. Then I don't have this. Why? I don't have this one. Although I have all these diseases I had. But only one is missing. Why? This is my answer. But later on, he became less selfish and he said that he will do without it. He will manage without it. And later on, what happened? That now he sat in isolation, in loneliness, he started thinking about him. That now, whether I'm going to die? No. He said that I am a very important person in the society. Look, he is going to be a big acquisition to the medical class. You know, that all these medical students, they are having a hospital very close to their medical colleges. And they go on round to the patients with their senior doctors. And the senior doctors go to every patient explaining their diseases to the students. And in this way, they get their knowledge, they get their degree, and they get their diploma. So here he is saying that he thought about himself that he would be a big acquisition to medical class. How? That now instead of going to every patient of the hospital, now I would be lying in the bed of the hospital and they would take the round around him. So just by taking a round again and again, they might be coming around him and the professors might be discussing his all these maladies. And just by instructing him, all these students of medical, they are going to get their diploma. That's his greatness, that he is thinking positively about himself, that he is going to be a big achievement for medical college students. Now, next, what he did? First, he thought proud about himself, that he is going to be a big acquisition and achievement for the students. So, he is going to do his positive role in the society. Secondly, what he did about himself? Now, once he thought that he was ill now, so being himself a doctor, first, just like a doctor, he felt his pulse. He put his hand on his pulse and he started counting his pulse rate. First, he thought that it was not working, it was totally dead. Later on, he observed that it was giving the counting of 147. Whereas, normally, a healthy person has 60 to 100 this pulse rate. So, he thought that he was having such a big pulse rate. Then, he felt his heart, he put his hand on his heart and he observed, he wanted to check whether it was throbbing or not. But he observed that first it was totally failed. But later on it started throbbing, so he felt relaxed. Then the third time, he checked his tongue. Just like doctor says to the patient, okay, take your tongue out of more tongue, and then he takes whole his tongue out just to check his tongue. Now he also did the same. He was himself patient, he was himself doctor, so he wanted to check his tongue. But although he couldn't do it, then when he left that British Museum, he was thinking about himself that when he entered that tongue, he entered happily. But now he is going to be in a dangerous and precarious condition because he is going to die now. Now, what happened? That now once again he thought about himself that he must go to his doctor now. So, he went to his doctor. Doctor is his close friend. And overall, he goes to him. He chats with him. But this time when he went, first he felt his pulse because he was a doctor. Then he looked at his tongue. Then he talked about the weather. It means that talking about the weather means that he didn't have any such type of problem. So, the doctor gave him clean sheet apparently that he didn't have an issue. But what happened? That he asked him what happened with him. So the very ridiculous and a very joking type of answer was coming out of the mouth of that writer. He said, look, life is very short. And if I would start telling you about my maladies, about my diseases, then it will take a lot of time. And your life will be ending, but my problems are never ending. So what I have, I am not going to tell you because I don't waste, I don't want to waste your time. So I am going to tell you that what I don't have. Yes, I don't have. That is housemaid's knee. Only one malady, one disease, one illness that's missing. That is housemaid's knee. So now the doctor was much astonished because he was a doctor. He put the question, okay, if you have come to know about such a big revelation, so tell me that how did you come to know? So he replied that a pharmacology book that was in his hand. So he observed that. So this was the turn of the doctor. So he stood up. He clutched his wrist. From wrist, he clutched him tightly. Suddenly, he hit him over the chest. He hit him there. Then on the third number, he butted him with his head. And then he wrote a prescription. He prescribed the medicine for him. Now he folded that paper, put that one in his pocket, and he went to the department. He went to that chemist shop. He handed over that one to chemist. But after reading that one, he returned and actually said that he wouldn't be in a position to help him. Why? Because he said that he didn't have any departmental store. If he had a departmental store, he would have helped him. Now, this was the turn of the patient, turn of the writer, that he observed what was written. Four things were written there. Number one, 1 pound beef steak every 6 hours. Number one, that is half kilogram of beef steak every 6 hours for the health of the patient. He said this is to be taken with every six hours. Secondly, walk of 10 miles every morning. Second thing that is there. Number third, at sharp 11, he must be in his bed at night. He must not be late from that point. And last but not the least, that's very important. Don't stuff your head against the thing with the things you don't understand. So that's the point. This was the actual message the writer wanted to give to every reader, that we observe in our society, in every society, such type of characters are found, in which we observe that whenever you are putting any problem, so he will start giving you his expert opinion, expert advice. Just like with the ear, that he knew each and everything about that problem. Whatever the problem you have, if you have headache, you will get the prescription. If you are having any problem with your future, he will be there to help you. So in each and every field, whether the person has his expertise or not, he is always going to give his expert opinion. So this was the story of the man who was hospital. Now we are going to discuss the questions and answers, inshallah, in our coming video. Thank you very much.